Hey you guys, welcome back to my channel. It's me, Mystic Beauty. Welcome back to the Cosmic Royal Family. Hey, how are you guys doing? Hope that you guys are doing amazing. If this is your first time here, welcome. And if you guys are returning, welcome back, all right? All right, we're gonna start with this deck. And let's just see what comes out, all right? I want to ask my spirit team, my guardians, my ancestors closest to the sun, my divine angels, that they shield me, cover me, and protect me, and they guard the spiritual door, and they don't let any nasty, negative, low vibrational energies through any spiritual doors that I may be opening up knowingly and unknowingly. As that they also guard my blind spots in God's name. Also, I also ask that they help me to be a clear channel. Yeah. Door to personal happiness. So something about y'all happiness. This is something about your happiness. All right. The universe is about to open up some new doors to you that's going to lead to some type of new beginning. Collective 34 could be significant. Yeah, 34 could be significant, but look like some new doors are about to be open to you guys, and you guys are going to be very happy, and these doors are going to lead to some healing. What is this? Divine masculine. For some of you guys, this door could be leading you towards your divine partner here. Healer of the ages. So this is definitely something about healing. But healer of the ages, door to personal healing and happiness in divine masculine. Some of you guys about to actually meet a new partner, and this person is actually going to be your real divine masculine energy here. For some of y'all, this person could be somebody that you already met. Like, you know who your divine masculine is. And Most High is about to heal a situation with your divine masculine here. All right. Under the deck, happy family. So this is like Ten of Cups energy here. Tell me more. And there's double rainbows here. So this is like a double new beginning. Somebody's about to have a double new beginning. You're about to have a new beginning with your divine masculine. And you're about to have just an overall new beginning with your health and your happiness and your healing. And because they keep saying this could be a divine masculine, your divine masculine that you already met, or this could be a new person. It depends on, you know, who you are. It's different for everybody, collective. Yeah, you guys have been anxious about this. So this new beginning, you've been feeling this new beginning coming for a while, but you've just been kind of anxious about it. Yeah, angel of love. Some of you guys have been praying to the angel of love. Asking the universe to heal your love life, heal your heart. You've been lonely. I'm picking up like on a lonely energy. Somebody in my collective been very lonely. Yeah, and detached. And you've been very detached. You've been lonely, but you have also been very detached. Someone could have detached from you. Archangel Samuel is here as well. And romantic love. So this is something about a romantic partner. Here, you could have detached from this person. This could have been your divine masculine that you detached from. All right, it says you're releasing old patterns and ideas that no longer serve your highest ideal of love. So you let this person go, even though you knew that they were your divine partner, your divine masculine here. Tell me more, Holy Spirit. So this is about romantic love. And for some of you guys, the person that you released, it wasn't your divine partner. You could have been dealing with a karmic. But it says the frequency of romantic love supports our journey to feel whole and complete through the experiences with and reflection of a conscious lover. So some of you guys, this is actually you manifesting your divine masculine. Listen. I have a big number of you guys that watch, but I'm picking up a bigger number of you guys. This is a new partner. Some of you guys, this could very well be someone from your past, but I'm picking up like a bigger number of this being a new partner, for real. This being a new partner. And it's saying that you are, when you detach from a toxic situation here, you started to align with your true love. You started to align with someone who's more on your energetic match, which is your divine masculine. Creativity, man, creativity. Because I saw solar plexus and I didn't take it. And that's about creativity. It says, you love to devise new ideas, innovations, and forms of illumination. So you guys are being asked to, you're being asked to be more creative right now. Something about that, that also be leading you to the door of value. Like your money, your blessings. Like, you know, you're going to have to tap into that, that solar plexus energy. So that you can be more creative. Also, the spirit is telling me that the universe is about to be very creative with how they're about to bring this divine masculine into your life. Yeah, they're about to be very, very, very creative here. So if you're the type of person, you don't ever go nowhere, you always stuck in the house, they're still about to make this person cross your path and make you cross paths with this person. They're going to get creative with it because some of y'all don't go nowhere. You don't go nowhere for real. Yeah, the temple path. Some of y'all, some of you guys kind of stay at home a lot, but I see the universe is going to create a way to get you guys to meet up, to cross paths with this person. Archangel Uriel and the thinking man. Then you also have this past person who's thinking about what they had with you guys. This person made a very big mistake. They definitely lost a diamond in the rough. You were the diamond in the rough collective. All right, this person made a very big mistake. Archangel Raphael is here. So you've had a lot of help with your healing, healing your heart. And this is why you guys are about to be victorious. This is why you're about to be winning. Tell me more, Holy Spirit. I heard that you guys have been telepathically communicating with your divine masculine already. Like, whether you know this or not, some of you guys, you probably don't even remember it, but in your dream space, you've been communicating with your new person. All right? Yeah, attachment. Clarify this attachment energy. Some of you guys, you still feel very attached to this past energy, though. Yeah, woman holding a heart crossing. Yeah. For some of you guys, you still feel very much attached to this past person. There's also, okay, so if this is somebody from your past, this thinking man here, he may still have an attachment with somebody from his past, and that's why you let him go. And whoever this person is that's crossing the connection, the woman holding the heart, this is somebody who may be holding on to this person. You're keeping him or herself attached to your person for their own satisfaction. And this is why you let this person go. Tell me more. Goddess of the moon here. So this could be your energy. This is divine feminine energy. The goddess of the moon is a divine feminine. So we literally have like the divine masculine and the divine feminine here on the table. Archangel Metatron is here. Walking away. So you guys were guided. You guys were guided by spirit to walk away from this past person who still has some type of an attachment to this woman that's actually crossing him. Like, this man is being crossed. Whether he know it or not, he's being crossed. Yeah. It's like, it's given that this feminine knows that this person wants to walk away from them and go be with this goddess of the moon energy here. But they're holding on to them for their own selfish gain, their own selfish reasons. Virtue is here. You acknowledge your loving and spiritual attributes that encourage others to grow. So you guys were literally put here to help people grow. All right, that's a part of your purpose, your calling, your mission is to help people grow. you are very encouraging to people, like very patient. Maybe you were very patient with this past person here, and maybe that was your the purpose of you crossing paths with this your past lover. It's because you were supposed to encourage this person to grow, and I feel like you did that. You did your part. You know, your time in this person's life, yeah, look at that healing. Yeah, you helped this person to heal. You helped this person to heal. You taught this person patience, love, kindness. Like, because you were all of those things to this person here. Love is patient. Love is kind. Okay, love is thoughtful. Like, you was all of these things to this person. You taught this past person how to love. You taught this past person, it's like you showed them that they were worthy of love. Maybe this person never felt like they were worthy of love, so they didn't know how to love you properly, right? Look at that integrity. You demonstrated integrity to this person. That your past energy never met anyone who actually had real integrity before. It says you demonstrate the truth and honesty of your soul and manifest your love with every action. Yeah, you love with integrity. You did everything with integrity. Collective, they never met somebody who was someone of good character and things like that. But you ultimately, you know, I feel like this person could have been some type of assignment. You were assigned to help this person heal, and you did that. And see, sometimes when we are assigned to do things like that, we don't actually get to witness our work. You see what I'm saying? Like, this person definitely learned a lot from you. They definitely benefited off your energy a lot, collective. But then when time was up, the universe separated you guys. When the mission was complete, you know, you guys were separated from this person here. So it's like, once they got the healing from you, they went probably back to somebody from their past, or they crossed paths with this new person here, and they learned a karmic lesson. It's kind of giving, you can't, this person could not appreciate someone like you with real integrity, real patience, real kindness, real healing, loving energy until they met this woman crossing, holding the heart, until they actually experienced someone who's a total opposite of you. This person never really had, they never had the real deal. So they, you can't possibly know what you have if you never had nothing to compare it to. So you were this person's first and last experience with an earth angel. You're quite literally an earth angel. They're never going to get to experience this again. Now they will probably meet other decent people, true enough, but they won't ever cross paths or be in a relationship. I ain't gonna say that. They'll probably cross paths with earth angels, but they won't get to be in a relationship with one. You are this person's personal experience with God's greatest creation. Tell me more, Holy Spirit. You broke open this person's heart chakra. You healed this person's broken heart. Wow, that's what this is about. This person's heart was broken and God sent you to heal their broken heart. That's what this was about. And once you did that, you were separated, and it broke your heart. Sometimes missions that we have with people, if they break our heart, collective. Yeah, look at this. Appreciation. Yeah, cornucopia, door to value. But the universe is finna show its appreciation to you for the role that you play. Yeah, you took action. You took action with this person, and you gave them the highest quality of divine love. Yeah. So because you took action and you did what you were supposed to do with this past person, this past situation here, the universe is about to bless you with your real divine masculine or your real divine feminine here. See, yin and yang. All right. You're also going to get the door to value. So blessings like money, prosperity, abundance, this fruit energy over here. Yeah. Cornucopia energy here. Yeah. Because Most High appreciate you for actually accepting the mission with this past person and completing the mission with this past person here, even though it hurt, because you love this person. Like, you fell in love with this person, and see, that was a part of the mission. You were supposed to fall in love with them. It wouldn't have worked if you didn't fall in love with them. All tied up. Alchemy is in reverse.
whoever this past person is connecting with could have attempted some type of failed alchemy to tie this person up. Or if they did, something is wearing off. So somebody attempted some type of magic to tie a person up, to bind a person up. Y'all, I got this energy from the last video. Yeah, tied up in alchemy in reverse. Some magic didn't work. Also, collective, if somebody tried some type of alchemy on you to tie you up, to bind you up, bind your blessings up or something like that, it's not working. You're still going to get to meet your real divine masculine, your real divine feminine, your real kingdom spouse, the yin to your yang, all right? You're still going to get the door to value, cornucopia, and the universe is still going to show you how appreciated and loved you are. So somebody attempted some alchemy that didn't work, or it was blocked. The universe blocked some type of magic trick from somebody to bind you up. The universe blocked it. Yeah. Oh, wow. Somebody really tried to bind you up. That's crazy. Someone wanted to bind your gifts up. You could be a very powerful magician. Look at this. Acceptance. Are you ready to release control of situations or people and lovingly embrace them? Embrace the rhythm of life. So you guys, you finally kind of accepted that this past situation was kind of like a divine assignment and a lesson for you and a lesson for this person here. And you know, you decided to release control. You decided to release control, and that's a good thing. Tell me more. You got to meet your real 2020 twin. Your real divine soulmate. If it's not a twin, it's going to be like a real, like a life partner. You're about to meet your life partner here. Yeah, so rest up. Some of you guys, you may meet this person through meditation. Or this person may call you to them during some type of meditation. This person is spiritual. Yeah, adjacent possibilities. Yeah. So many doors. I'm telling you, the universe is going to open up every angle for you and this person to cross paths. Every angle. So any path you take, you're going to cross paths with this person, just so you know. And whoever this person is, there's going to be so many. You guys are going to, the possibilities are going to be endless with this person here. Yeah. There's so much you're going to get accomplished with this person. This person is going to prioritize you guys. They're going to make you a priority. You guys are going to make each other a priority. Tell me more. Look at this. Envy. Heartbroken. So this past energy, because they may be kind of envious, or they're going to be envious. This past person who was like some type of assignment, this past person could have been like a karmic, and you was assigned to save their soul for real. And look at this. This shouldn't even be in this deck. It says immediately the way you project yourself, do it on your own. First house energy. And the first house, who you are, your desires, and your actions. Somebody is envious of how you do things on your own. It could be this past person here. And I mean, no lie, you really did help this person to grow for real, collective. But see, this person didn't make you a priority. And see, they had to love you and lose you in order for their heart to be open. Maybe it's not them that's envious of you. Y'all got somebody that's envious around you guys. I'm not just going to pin it on them. Somebody is envious because you have your priorities in order. You do it on your own. It says the way you project yourself, like, you know, how you show yourself, how you present yourself. And it says, do it on your own, how you do things on your own. Yeah. It says who you are, your desires, your actions. Somebody is envious. And it's like the fact that you got yourself together. This person is envious of that, or it's breaking their heart. It's breaking their heart to see Clarify this heartbroken energy. Somebody is envious of to see you get your desires, to see you take actions and, you know, making yourself a priority. And I'm also getting somebody's going to be envious that this new person is going to make you a priority. Because whoever you're the person you're about to meet, this person's going to make you a priority. That's all I keep hearing. Like, they're going to make you a priority. No matter what, I don't care what this person doing, where they at in the world, they're going to check in on you. They're going to message you. You're going to hear from them a couple times a day. You're not going to go days and weeks and months without hearing from this person. They're going to make you a priority. Somebody's going to be so jealous and envious and heartbroken because somebody's making you a priority. It could be this past person whose heart is now clear. Like, this person is now their feelings over you. But maybe you was never meant to be with this person. This is for somebody specific. Like, maybe for real, you were just meant to heal this person. I heard break them out of their shell. Tell me more, Holy Spirit. Freedom. Yeah. So now you guys were led to break free. You were led to break free from this past person. This person is heartbroken. Yeah, door to spirit. So, you know, spirit guided you guys and showed you guys the way out, and you guys healed from that situation. This past person is upset about this because it's like now they want you. Yeah, look at that willingness. Now this past person is willing to give you everything. Yeah, because you're about to be the woman holding the coin. It's like, put some respect on my name. This person see you as the woman holding the coin or the man holding the coin. Yeah. And now this person is like, they respect you now. This past person used to didn't respect you. Yeah, divine feminine in reverse. See, this, thank you. This person did not see you as a divine feminine. They didn't think you were the divine feminine for real. Your individuality though, but you for real. It says you leave a unique stamp on love. Everything you do, you left a unique stamp on this person that can never be removed. This person now know that you are the divine feminine. This person is now seeing you and respecting you. They see, like, they're willing to put in the work and the action now. They're willing to do all the things that they didn't do the first time. This person respect you. Now, this person, this past person, want to make you a priority. But the problem is you finna meet your real person now. But see, this person didn't see you as a divine feminine. They didn't. Yeah, belief. This person didn't believe that you were the divine feminine, but you made this person out of a believer. This person didn't even know what a divine feminine was or a divine masculine was. But this person just, when this person thought of, I don't know, their dream girl, their dream guy, they didn't put you on like the list for whatever reason. Yeah, they were very hostile with you. Because I'm getting that your real blessings, your real gifts, your crown was hidden from this person. So they could have been hostile with you because they didn't think that you were their person for real. They didn't believe that. And you made a believer out of this person collective. You have the sun, your crown. You are the daughter or the son of Most High. You're a chosen one. Now this person is hostile because now they realize that they've let the blessed one, the chosen one, the earth angel get away. The star, you are the star. You know, the sun is what, the biggest star in the sky for real. You are the biggest star this person has ever came across in life and ever will. They will never cross another star like you again. For some of you guys, you are going to be an actual literal, you are an actual star, but I mean, like, you're going to be like a celebrity. If you may already be a celebrity for real, but if you are, you're about to be a bigger celebrity. And if not, you're about to be like a celebrity red carpet in front of magazines, you know, headlining major podcasts. Like, you're about to be a real celebrity for real, okay? And this person is hostile because they want to cooperate with you, but you don't want to cooperate with them no more because the lesson is over. The contract is over for real. Yeah, the contract is over. What is this? Release is in reverse. This person don't want to release you. They're wanting, it says the frequency of allowance invites us to be open to whatever comes our way. This person want to allow things to flow with you and them now. They want to allow love to flow, but in the past they didn't. They didn't want to. Yeah, heart chakra in reverse. This person's heart chakra was closed off. And this person did not want to change for you. Yeah, but you made a believer out of this person. It's something about your crown, for real. Your crown was revealed to this person, collective. Your ranking was revealed to this person. Your purpose, your uniqueness, who you really are, for real, was revealed to this person, collective. All right, and this person never saw this coming. And see, that was a lesson for this person as well. They had to cross paths with someone of a rare breed. All right, a rare energetic breed, and lose them, not appreciate them, lose them. Like, this person met a real star. Like, whoever you are, you a real freaking star. You just don't know it yet. You just don't know. And this person's going to have to watch you on the big screen. They're going to have to watch you, your face plastered everywhere and people talking about you. It's like, this person's going to be telling people stories of how they knew you. How they knew you. Look, it says, rejected God's gift, but it came out in reverse. This person don't want to reject this gift no more. See, they rejected you, but that was a part of the... Listen, Most High knew this person's going to reject you. Okay, but this is how this person's going to get this lesson. Now you may be a praying man, or this person is praying. It's like rejecting a gift from God actually made this person get closer. Rejecting this earth angel energy here, this person actually, they're heartbroken. They are, because it's like you cracked this person's heart. See, yeah, my heart just started fluttering. This person's heart is so freaking broken because you are truly, truly a earth angel. You are a goddess, or you're a god energy. This is like some shit heard about but rarely ever really seen, for real. This person is now, ever since they have came to this awakening, they're realizing that you are everything. You check off every box, then some. But see, this person, they didn't see it because their heart was closed off. No lie. Whatever you poured into this person, whatever you talked to this person about, this person still think about conversations that y'all had, how you poured knowledge, wisdom, love into them. They still think about that, collective. So this person is repenting, asking God for forgiveness. This person is actually going to, receive some type of ranking. Yeah. Once they're done healing, collective, this person's gonna, they're gonna be exalted. They're gonna get to go to the next level, all because they rejected this gift from God. And it kind of sent a tower moment in this person's life, because you're the gift. You are the gift. And it's like this person rejecting you, and you loving on this person, them rejecting you, you walking away, this person having full access to heaven through you and losing full access of heaven through you. This broke this person down to their knees. Now they're praying. This person ain't never prayed this much in their life, and that's what God intended. God is like, okay, I got your attention. I got your attention now. Now we can talk. Now you want to talk. All right. So it's like, I don't know, collective. You walking away from this person after they finally realized who you were to them brought them closer to God. This person is gaining an intimate relationship with Most High because of you. That's earth angel energy, for real. That's what an angel do for you. Change your life. Change your life, collective. See, in the past, this person tried to pull you down. They tried to pull you down, crabs in a bucket energy. They could have left you for somebody who was a crab in a bucket energy. Here, this person lost some financial, like they lost their job. Like, so they did have to go through some karma. They may still be going through karma. This person could have suffered some type of job loss because maybe they tried to pull you down. Yeah, this person, they went through it. Warring angels came out. This person paid some severe karma, collective. You may be a warring angel in the spirit. Some of y'all are warring angels. Yeah, there it is. Spiritual test passed. You passed some type of spiritual test. You dealing with this person was an assignment. See, you are training as a warring angel. That's why, some of you guys are training to be warring angels. Other you guys, you are warring angels, but you know, that was a part of it. You fought for this person's soul. So it was a constant spiritual battle over this person's soul. And you was fighting for this person's soul. You literally came in and you camouflaged as this person's lover. Whole time, this was some type of spiritual setup. This was a battle over souls, and you won. You passed the spiritual test. But because this person crossed an angel energy here, see, you, if you're a warring angel collective, you're like a prayer warrior. That's what I'm trying to say. You're like a prayer warrior for real. And you get down in the spirit too. Some of you guys have the ability to summon warring angels to you. But I'm getting like some of y'all are training. That's why I said spiritual test pass. You're training to be a warring angel. That's why the battle's been so heavy. Like it's attack after attack after attack. Brutal spiritual attacks after spiritual attacks because you're in training. This person was an assignment. This person had a high ranking entity. A legion of high ranking entities wanted this person. Like, man, this person was under full demonic control and possession. And then you came along and because of your position, it set things off. You set this person free. I heard, how can I ever repay you? See, this person in the physical, they don't know what happened, but they know that their life is different since crossing paths with you. But spiritually, this person may come to you spiritually and say, thank you. Woo. Spiritual manipulation, spiritual warrior. Here it is. Tell you, this was all spiritual. This was all spiritual. And you remember I picked up earlier, somebody could have tried to bind y'all up. A Jezebel, here it is. Some of y'all, a Jezebel that was connected to this person could have tried to do something to block your blessings or something because they was mad about this person that you don't even deal with no more. But because you are a spiritual warrior in training to be a warring angel, okay, or you could be both of these or both warring spirits, this spiritual manipulation don't work on you. It don't work on your kind. It don't. Wow. Listen. Some of you guys, there's a Jezebel spirit. You don't even know this person personally, but this person is definitely a dark demon, feminine demon. Okay. Like a succubus or something, or the Jezebel herself, him or herself. But this person tried to do something spiritually to block your blessings, your divine inheritance. So this is about the blessings that are assigned to you since birth. Somebody wanted to stop. So like if you have a business, somebody could have did some magic to try to slow your business down. If you have a channel, somebody could have did something to try to slow your numbers down. But ultimately, like you probably could slow it down for a little while, but you can never, ever, ever stop what God has for somebody. You cannot stop what God has for somebody. And see, this Jezebel trying to play God and block your blessings. Okay, somebody could have lost their job because of some spell work. Like a Jezebel could have did some type of spell work to make you lose your job. But you ended up working for yourself and making more money than you ever did. See, that's how God take what the enemy meant to destroy you for your highest good. So sometimes, you know, evil people who are just puppets of the devil, they think that they won because they see small effects of their little spell work, but they just don't know they're being used too. God is using them to bless you. So whatever this Jezebel did, the spiritual manipulation that did that probably caused you to lose your job or lose some money, you're going to get that back times 1,000. God is going to put you, it's like it's getting you closer to where you were supposed to be the whole time. Getting you closer to your north node, your divine purpose, getting you into alignment. All of this is about your divine inheritance. Somebody think they're going to stop you, block your divine inheritance. They got another thing coming. Somebody got another thing coming if they think that they're going to do some type of failed, weak alchemy work to block to bind you up. Somebody tried to bind your finances up. Somebody tried to bind you up so you won't receive what God has for you. Somebody could have did a reading on you or something and found out that you're about to meet your real counterpart. And they're trying to bind you up so that you won't ever meet this person. But that's a lie. The devil is a liar. You're still going to meet this person. Somebody did something, try to like block your money or the flow of your money. The devil is a liar. You're still finna get paid. Okay? Yeah, somebody's fallen twin. So this could be over like a fallen counterpart or a fallen lover. It says twin flame, fallen angel. Somebody wanted you to be a fallen angel so bad. So if this is not over a fallen twin, somebody wanted you to be a fallen angel. They want you to lose your ranking. Yeah, somebody wanted your health. Somebody wanted you to have like being bad health and to work hard with a sweatshop energy. Somebody wanted a warring angel, a spiritual warrior, to be in bad health. I'm talking about literally whoever you are, you are trained in the spirit to fight in God's army. And they wanted you to be in bad health, lose your money, and have to work hard with the sweatshop energy for the rest of your life. They wanted you to lose your rank, and they wanted you to be a fallen angel. This Jezebel wanted this. You may not even know this person, like, for real. This probably somebody just watched you. Or this person could be connected to somebody of your past. But never that. Never that. They'll fall before you fall. They'll fall before you fall, collective. Look at this. Contract ended. Listen. This person about to, they're about to, this Jezebel about to meet their maker. Something about the end for this Jezebel, because they cannot take what God got for you. It says God-given talent. Listen, what God has for me is for me. That's what is given. You see, Most High Hand is raising his child up out of the crowd. Out of all of these people here, this child is chosen out of the group. Everybody wants to be chosen, but he only chooses one. This is you. This Jezebel cannot block what Most High has for you. And I don't care what type of spell work somebody do to think that they're going to stop you from getting to the top, stop your flow, make you lose stuff, whatever. You don't take no losses. God's kids don't take no losses, okay? Only lessons and then elevation. Only lessons and then elevations. There is no such thing as losses when it comes to earth angels and chosen ones. There is no loss. See, this is what this Jezebel is finding out, because it's like somebody doing some spell work. They've been doing this for a while and they're trying to figure out, why is this not working? It seemed like it'll work a little bit, and then their numbers are double. Like, it seemed like their life is good. They're unfazed. That's because you're chosen for real. And whoever this Jezebel is, they don't want to believe this. They do not want to believe you are amongst the elites. They don't want to believe it. But somebody wanted to try to, they wanted to end something for you with end contract. They wanted to end your divine contract. Never. Their contract is about to come to an end. Like, this is giving death energy. Somebody done played in so much black magic against the earth angel that they probably finna, look at that, convicted by God and period. And see, you a praying woman, period. Yeah. Somebody's about to get convicted by God. This Jezebel about to get in trouble. Because they played in so much black magic against a prayer warrior, a praying woman, or a praying man. See, the prophecy, this how, listen, I tell people, the worst type of person that you want to betray and hurt and do something to is somebody to go to God about everything. You do not want to be the one doing black magic on somebody who has a real intimate relationship with God. I'm telling you, because he will lay hands on you about this one. And about this one, he will lay hands on you about his kids. He will come to you personally and destroy your whole life. God's wrath is nothing to play with. God's wrath is nothing to play with. And this person is being convicted. Yeah, convicted by God. They're being convicted, collective. This Jezebel, or this could be a man or a woman in this Jezebel energy here, trying to block what God has for you, trying to block you and stop you, bind you up. Death, like I said, is giving death energy. I knew I felt death in the air. I knew it. Yeah. Somebody don't want you to be like a power couple. It's something about somebody's trying to stop you from meeting your real person here. Somebody don't want you to meet your real person. Whoever this new person is your real life partner. You're going to be a power couple with this man or this woman. Yeah. Ancient, you guys are going to be an ancient royal couple with ancient knowledge. This person's going to also have access to ancient knowledge. They come from an ancient royal lineage, just like you. Somebody done played in so much spell work. I'm telling you, the black horse is going to come see them. The black horse is going to come see them, and they're going to beg for their life, and they're going to beg for their life. And this may fall on deaf ears, for real. All them begging may fall on deaf ears. Yeah, touch not my anointed, do my prophets no harm. And this is the part where they left out. They didn't read that part. This Jezebel didn't read the fine print. Mm-mm. Thank you. See, look at that. Somebody finna be real worried. Real, real worried, collective. This could be a woman thinking about a man. Somebody's about to be real worried. Yeah. Over what's finna happen to them. All right, for something that they did to an empress energy. An empress, a divine feminine energy. Somebody's about to be real worried. This is crazy. Yeah, this person was envious. They was envious of this empress here. This earth angel, this angelic energy here. And they don't want them to get this sacred union that's coming. There's a sacred union. The angels will attend this ceremony. This connection that you're going to have with this your life partner that you're about to meet is going to be so sacred. And for some of y'all, maybe this is somebody from your past or somebody that they watch you and you don't know, or they're connected to your person. Somebody really do not want this empress. And I'm going to be honest, this past person, even though you taught them a lesson, it's like this person is angry. Envy came out twice. This person is so envious now. They just don't want you to have nothing if you don't have it with them. And I promise you, you're getting this divine connection with this ancient partner of yours. This is an ancient love. You've known this person for lifetimes and lifetimes and lifetimes. Okay? This is back in horse and carriage days. Wow. Ancient royal lovers coming back together. That's what this is about. Divine ancient royal lovers coming back together in this lifetime. Somebody's wondering, do you still think about them? There's a masculine that wonders, do you still think about them, collective? Okay. Yeah. You're being protected from somebody. So whoever this person is, this man is, the wonder, do you still think about them? You're being protected from them. Your ancestors are shielding you because, like I said, you've already did your part. You've already learned your lesson. You've already taught them a lesson. You've already, like, you completed, you passed your spiritual test. Remember? You passed your spiritual test. Congratulations. And now you have a new beginning. Yeah. You have an angel that's lining your path towards this new beginning here. With someone whose heart is as pure as yours. Okay? All right, I hope you guys enjoyed this reading. If you have not subscribed to the channel, make sure that you do so. Thumbs up the video, hit the notification bell so that you won't miss a beat. All right, I love you guys to life. Peace.